to be honest, mate. That's kind of all your football life just kind of builds up to that moment, doesn't it? You don't like go over the top and act too excited and too happy, because obviously you lost the game 4-1, but the best moment of my life so far, right, definitely.
How much notice did you get, and you know, did you manage, did you have to scramble family over there, or how did it work?
No, the manager never really said it, because just put us in, gave us an opportunity, and obviously so grateful for that. You don't expect it, do you know what I mean? Because he's played obviously Big Craig so much when he was fit, and then Angus has played every minute since he's come in. So me and Zander have done a lot of warm ups between us. So it was nice to be on the receiving end of one for a change. Aye, that was nice. It just fills you with energy again, and just kind of keeps you going, kind of with belief that you can do all right in that situation. Obviously, we lost goals and set pieces, which is kind of unlike us. But I felt as though we actually done all right in the game. I know the scoreline says 4-1, but three set pieces and then a counter attack later on in the game. I felt as though we actually done really well with the ball last night in the game. So it was nice to take part, my mum and dad managed to go over, so that was a great feeling as well.
When you saw the team that France had put out, were you delighted, or was there a wee bit of trepidation, or were you saying, no, listen, this is what I want to be on the same pitch as some of these players?
The manager kind of warned us that he felt as though they were going to come strong. He's usually good at that. He uses his knowledge to try and guess what our teams are doing. He always gets opposition team there or thereabouts, so he'd have a feeling they were going to come strong, so we were prepared for that. And then obviously when we took the lead, you're thinking, oh, here we go, can we hang on? But I think we just kind of poked the air a wee bit, didn't we?
Wasn't it quite a James McFadden moment? back to the wall after that.
I mean, unfair perhaps, accusations flying around that maybe Scotland had a few players that had partied a wee bit on Sunday night. Is that unfair?
Aye, that probably would be unfair. Aye, I think the manager kept a lid on it. He kept a close eye on us. We had a good time. Obviously, he's a really good manager. Obviously, he gives the boys that bit of space and that bit of time to enjoy themselves. I think the boys gave him a lot back.
What was the curfew?
About 10:30 or something.
Are you buying that for 1 second?
I'm buying it, mate. I believe you. You've got that defensive side ease, but also you can score goals. Do you know the reason why that is? And what would you say the manager's main attribute is for the team?
Against England, we never really had that kind of control in the game and that edge, and I think he wanted us to not just stop the opposition last night. Of course, they were good, but when we had the ball, he wanted us to play. He wanted us to try and create. He was saying to me, didn't want me just to go long. He wanted me to try and play short. So we stopped the opposition well. I think there's a massive emphasis on that's not the only thing we do. We need to bring our own kind of personality to the game. We need to try and bring our own selves to the game, because we've got a lot of really, really good players. It's just trying to find that way to maybe challenge the top opposition a wee bit more, and how can we create chances more now, because I think the possession was 50-50 last night against France and France. So it just shows we're going in the right direction, and the manager's always looking for small wee ways to improve the team as well. So
you face a penalty from your own brother, and then fast forward 10 days and it's the small matter of Kylian Mbappe. Had you done your research? What were you thinking when he's putting the ball down?
It was quite surreal, wasn't it? Like, I'm just thinking to myself, like, that's actually Mbappe standing in front of me. I had a feeling I was going to go up my left, and I went low, and I probably went just a bit too low. So it wasn't to be, maybe get the next one against another player, hopefully. But me, Zander, Angus, we all talked with the goalie coach. And
you got a few fingers through, didn't you? You did get it. Yeah. You did kind of touch it.
I wonder if there was a message from your brother saying you got closer to Mbappe's than you did to mine. Is that not arrived yet?
I told him I didn't want him greeting, so I just let him score.
Zander got half the game as well, and I saw him saying that you two have actually, you grew up together, so it was a kind of special moment as well. Was it nice in a way to be able to share it with him last night?
It was really nice, Gordon, to be honest. I'm not just saying that because I think we both just really wanted each other to do well in the game, because we know Angus is probably going to go back and play the next couple of games anyway. So I just really wanted each other to do well. I've known each other since his dad was a big Joker fan, and my dad played with Joker back when I was 5 or 6 and he was 8 or 9. So we used to run about Joker on the pitch together. So to then share that moment last night, it was really good, and that just kind of sums up the relationship all the boys have got in the squad.
How did it feel kind of watching it as a squad on Sunday, and the realisation setting in that it's on, even though we've known for a while that, you know, you'd put yourselves in a good position?
I think it got to about the 89th minute, and then we were kind of maybe hoping for a Norway equaliser, so we still had a chance of a top in the group. But then we seen the referee put up 8 minutes on the board, and we're like, no, equaliser just yet. The challenge just becomes to play well at your club, try and get in your club team. The manager always tells us he'll be watching the club football, so make sure you do well there, make sure you stay in his plans, and just try and get in the squad again. And then if you get in the squad, you try and get in the team, and if you're not picked in, you support the boys. So the process remains the same, and I'll just try and follow that again.
Well done, Liam. Thanks for taking the time.
Well done, mate.
Cheers, lads. Thank you. Cheers.
Good man.